Hi, in this video, we learn about how to apply the theory of multiple intelligence in our classrooms. Many a time we notice that a child seems intelligent but is not doing well on tests. Why do you think that is so? We are all aware of Howard Gardner's theory of multiple intelligences, where he talks about the eight kinds of intelligences: kinesthetic, interpersonal, linguistic, mathematical, naturalistic, intrapersonal, visual, and musical. How do we group our children in school? Usually by age, right? What does your classroom look like? Does it look like this? Or like this, where students are of different abilities and capabilities? If our classrooms are so diverse, how do we help students of different intelligences in our classroom? Differentiated instruction is the answer. Differentiation means teaching and helping every child feel successful. If every child does not feel successful, then he or she is not learning well. Teachers need to recognize and accommodate these learning preferences and plan for differentiated instruction. How do we do this? Fit every child into the learning process and get them excited about learning. You will see a spark in them that you wouldn't have seen before. Confidence and self-esteem increases. What is differentiated instruction? It means anything that accommodates differences in your learners and as a result leads them to learn more effectively. It is a process by which teachers provide opportunities for learners to achieve their own potential, working at their own pace through a variety of different learning activities. In simple terms, it means, if I can't learn the way you teach me, can you please teach me the way I can learn? What differences among students must we weave into our teaching? Differences among students can be numerous. However, only those differences matter to us which are pedagogically relevant. For example, we know that students differ in their heights and weights, but we also know that it is not pedagogically relevant. How do you differentiate then? First, take time to understand your students. Be aware of the different strengths and weaknesses. Be aware of the different ways in which your students learn and take into account of this into your planning. Include a range of activities and strategies, taking into account the variety of learning styles. How do you know your learners? Based on the subject you teach or on the whole, you could undertake some kind of subject or subject skills related assessment in one of the early sessions. This is like a pre-test. This will allow you to get to know your students and be aware of where you need to differentiate. You will be able to build an initial group profile, which can be added to later. Create a conducive environment. The environment should be conducive and non-threatening. Students should be made to recognize and value individual differences so that they can support one another in their learning. Make time to speak to each student individually in order to give feedback and support. Develop individual targets that are appropriate to the student. Specify when you are free to talk to them. Also have clarity of instruction. Aims and objectives should be made clear at the start of the new lesson. Each activity should be clearly explained, and students should understand what you want them to do and why you want them to do it. Give manageable tasks and clear short-term goals in order that they can be motivated by success. Establish ground rules. Discuss with students and establish ground rules. Students need to be made aware of the need to respect and support other students. They could be linked to equality and diversity, types of bullying, appropriate language, and appropriate behavior. Spread understanding. Students should be made aware that not everyone works at the same pace, and those that work quickly should not dominate the lesson. How can you do this? By direct questioning, electing spokespersons, limiting answers, and other classroom management strategies. You can also define different types of activities. Explain the activity that will be employed and the benefits of each activity, whether it is a paired work, group work, or a peer assessment. Does having multiple intelligence limit a student's learning? Can a student say, I'm musically intelligent, so I won't learn math? Or can the student say, I'm more logically, mathematically intelligent, I can't get words, so no English for me? No. Instead, students should think about how to use their strengths to help them in all subjects. Maybe that musically intelligent student should make up a song to help her learn the periodic table of elements or learn math formulae. Expand upon traditional activities. Traditional school activities focus primarily on linguistic and logical mathematical intelligences. But here are some ways to reach any intelligence type in your classroom. For students with linguistic intelligence, ask them to write a story about what they study. If they're learning a process, have them write an instructional manual or give a how-to speech. Writing scripts, making videos, or designing a brochure are other good activities for this intelligence. For students with logical mathematical intelligence, beyond doing math problems, they should focus on logical reasoning and problem solving. Can students conduct a survey and graphically represent the results? For English or history class, use a debate to teach the basics of logic and rhetoric. Ask students to function the way a real-life scientist does, using logic and math to solve a problem or propose a hypothesis. For students with bodily kinesthetic intelligence, let them do a role play, dance, or physically stimulate a scientific process. Let them use manipulatives and math. Have them build a model with clay or create a collage about a concept learned. For students with visual spatial intelligence, let these picture smart students draw a diagram, illustrate a group project, or develop a PowerPoint presentation. Encourage them to use symbols or colors to help them make sense of their notes. And since they may struggle with the traditional note-taking methods, this may help. Graphic organizers can also help them. For students with musical intelligence, these students may be gifted musicians or have a good ear for rhythm and a sense of pattern. Consider having them create a rap song about their subject or make connections between sound, music, and the information you're teaching. They could also create podcasts and other auditory products. For students with interpersonal intelligence, these students are usually the ones who can't stop talking. Take advantage of the chatty energy through class discussions or group work, and let them teach the class or use technology to have them interact with others via Skype, chat, etc. For students with intrapersonal intelligence, give these students assignments that challenge them to make connections between their personal experiences and the class subject. Blogs, journals, essays, all these help. Let them develop a portfolio of individual assignments. And for students with naturalistic intelligence, incorporate the outside world to hold these students' attention. Field trips would be ideal, but anything that allows them to get some fresh air and interact with plants and animals will help. Take the class outside on a nice day or invite these students to help you take care of a classroom garden. Use natural items like flowers or rocks for math manipulatives or help them write a poem about the sky. Go one step at a time. Coming up with assignments to reach all the multiple intelligences can be very time consuming, so start small. Pick one or two intelligences that you don't normally use in your lessons and find a way to incorporate them. Interpersonal, intrapersonal, and naturalistic intelligences can be some of the easier ones to start with. Another solution: choose one common assignment and brainstorm alternatives for students with multiple intelligences. Let the students choose how they turn in their assignment. They could compose a song, build a diorama, they could make a graphical representation or do a role play. You might be surprised at the results. Try what works best for your class. Do let me know if this module has helped you integrate the multiple intelligence theory in your classroom. You can contact me at thehotshotteacher@gmail.com.